Somebody's figured out that that would be me.
Okay.
do think that this is the case. Today.
I'm doing fine.
Thank you. going pretty so far without a hitch.
Excellent. So, have you seen Tony about?
Yeah, he set the microphone.
Because I noticed the pool theater is open.
Okay.
So do you know if the plan has changed? Or?
No. Rodney called me earlier.
We did, but there were some meetings and stuff like that, but I think it would have been a lot easier if you were there. I think it would just
be more
keep everything,
my perspective, I would be cool with that.
So that's why I'm trying to get you involved, so that everybody's aware of everything, because this time a lot of it was information transferred between you, which worked this time, but that makes me nervous that I'm going to miss something and forget to tell somebody.
You get that straight away, and then I'm going to show you real quick about how this feels. Same thing with the partner website.
I'm going home. I'm going to be hanging out with my wife tonight because I'm here tomorrow night and Saturday, Sunday. So.
Get the last bit of rest.
Thanks.
All right. I'll go get some.
This was the dining hall. For those students who were here, imagine coming in here with all of your Bennett sisters and having family style meals at least 3 times a day. I can't imagine it yet. And I'm standing where Dr. Alma Adams' art lab used to be. And you all are sitting where the music labs used to be. So you are in the history or in the memory of some very profound activities and academic programs at Bennett College. And we're grateful because that serves as a foundation for what we really decided to do with this building when we renovated it. We wanted to preserve history. We wanted people to always remember from whence Bennett came. And the Wilbur Steele Hall serves as one of those buildings. I would like to ask Dr. Paul, first of all, let me thank Dr. Linda Parker. She's somewhere in the back for her music. Thank you very much. And Dr. Paul Baker will bring
to the Board of Trustees, Dr. Fusall, the 17th President of Bennett College on her inauguration week, Provost Joyce Blackwell, leadership team, and all the faculty, staff, and students and friends that make up the great Bennett College family, good evening. Welcome to Bennett College in the Steel Gallery as we enjoy the artistic creations of our featured artist, Synthia St. James. On behalf of the Division of Humanities, it is a pleasure to have each one of you here today. Our goal as a division is to offer exposure to the fine arts, visual arts with exhibitions, featured concerts, and dramatic plays. Many great artists have come through Bennett. Aaron Douglas, the noted Harlem Renaissance painter, Alma Adams, artist and supporter of the arts, Andrina Coleman, globally noted textile artist, and today, Synthia St. James. Art courses in 1926 at Bennett began as a part of the home economics curriculum to include interior design, costume design, and art appreciation, led by the first official art professor here, Catherine Patton, who earned her degree from Tennessee State Normal College. So art has always been a resident at Bennett for a long time, and with the dedication of events such as this, art will continue to be a local here at Bennett College. Once again, welcome. Thank you.
Thank you very much. That was a little shocking. I don't really consider myself an artist, but thank you. Thank you. Just a few housekeeping things. Please be careful around the walls. They do move. They have wheels underneath them, so do not miss the walls. This is really an exciting time for us. You know, to have this exhibit opening at Bennett College and to see all of you here to celebrate with us, we are really pleased. And I would hope that this is not the last time you come here, but this is the beginning of the first time that you will be here. At this time, I will ask Mr. Harry Schwartz Turfel, did I get it right? With Mr. Harry, if he would come forward.
Hi everybody, I'm so glad to see this room pretty filled tonight. I usually talk off the cuff and I always blow it, so this time I wrote my remarks down. I'd like to start off saying that I do think this is the most beautiful gallery space in all of Greensboro. Everyone should know about this space. It's an honor to Bennett, it's an honor to Greensboro, this space. So tell everyone when we have shows, bring people. I'm especially fond of it. If you go out Market Street, you can still see it when the sun's going down. It looks very beautiful, it's a little jewel box. So I think about, the reason I bring that up is I think about it every day I walk through the doors. I think about this space and how I can honor and bring this place alive. Some of the people who renovated this space in 2005 are here today. Every day I walk in, and I wonder how I can honor them. When Dr. Cole and her team, including Andrina and Dr. Adams, who couldn't be here today, she's in D.C. serving us, getting ready to be our next congressperson. Uh, when they remade this space, they had a vision for what this space could be. And when I first came here to Bennett, I saw this space and I saw the potential that they saw. Now during the inauguration of Dr. Rosalind Fuse Hall, it's a special occasion. We've invited one of America's finest artists to show her work and make a special painting in honor of Bennett College. And also I'll put a plug in by $60, hand signed. It's beautiful. She's been to Bennett before, but she's never made an inauguration painting. And I think as Cynthia's work has grown, Bennett has grown, and we have grown. And now with a new president, I'm excited about where Bennett's going, because from the beginning, Dr. Fuse Hall has come and been a really big supporter of the arts. And I think tonight is a real sign. Watch out, the walls do move. They're very easily moved. They seem so solid. They are not solid. They're like little go-karts. Don't watch out. So tonight, I regard tonight as an opening, not just for Cynthia, and not just inauguration of Dr. Fuse Hall, but it's also a big step forward for the arts in Bennett and for the arts in Greensboro. So thank you very much for coming.
I'd like to thank the Planning Committee for this event. We worked very, very hard. This was so difficult. No, it wasn't. This is one of the most enjoyable planning committees I've ever served on, I guess because of my love of the arts, but also because it was Synthia St. James. Harry Swartz Turfel, Audrey Franklin, just raise your hand. Leroy Summers, who kept us within budget. Bernetta Harper, Belonda Burney, and Wanda Mobley. Thank you all very much for serving on that planning committee for this event. At this time, I know everybody's been waiting to hear from the artist, so I've asked a person who has met her several times, a graduate of Bennett College, Miss Angela Fitzgerald, if she would introduce the artist. And Angela graduated in 1975.
Good evening. I do bring greetings from the African American Atelier located in the Greensboro Cultural Center downtown. And it is my honor to do this introduction this evening. I had the opportunity to meet Ms. St. James on three different occasions. Two happened to be at the Atelier. She's had exhibits there, and also in collaboration with Steele Hall and the Bennett Gallery. And she did workshops for us. I also had the honor of giving her a guided tour of our new International Civil Rights Center and Museum on one of her visits. And I thought that was just so awesome to be able to do that and have her explain to me how it touched her as we moved through the building. Now, we have a wonderful bio. We're all intelligent and we can read this. But beyond that, one little tidbit that I wanted to share, and we always include in our educational programs with the young women that come from Harry's class over to the gallery. We talk about the importance of the business of art, as well as being an artist. Now, I don't know if you know that Cynthia is an accountant. And she has a book, and she talks, and she teaches classes, and she can tell you all about the business side, as well as the art side. And it's so important, and I think that's one thing that's missed among our young artists. I also read just today that you sold your first piece of artwork at the age of 20. I think that's phenomenal.
As an accountant.
As an accountant. So just think of the possibilities and your students, and you have her here, you can pick her brain. She's a wealth of knowledge. And I will leave it at that. You read the bio. But I would leave on this last note, it is truly my honor to introduce Synthia St. James, Bell Ringer Award honoree. She said she was going to add this to her resume.
Now we get to the short person. One of my boyfriends told me when I was in high school, good things come in small packages. I gotta get this out because I'm gonna just say a little bit more. Yeah. I could do like that. Thank you. Great. That's great. Okay. First, I want to not only if you call for being the very first person to even think about commissioning me to create a painting for her inauguration, being the first president to do so. And for those of you that weren't at the luncheon earlier today, there have already been two other presidents that have commissioned. And there is a fourth one in the making. He'll be the first man. And it was so cute to me in another way, because I love to laugh. I like to look at the humorous side, is that all the women are tall and he's a short guy. But I would be so proud to do that. I would announce it, but it's not on paper yet, so you're not supposed to do that. But there's a lot of things up that are incredible, but I first want to thank my brother artist, Harry. You know, and I think everything is beautiful. And I didn't want to come in until everybody else. So thank you. Yeah. I've done a lot of work here, and I get kind of mixed up, because I remember I was suddenly the craze after the first Kwanzaa stamp in 97. People even wanted me to come to Alaska. I said, are there black people in Alaska? And they were asking me to ride on sleds with dogs, and it just didn't seem appealing to me to be riding through the snow, and you know, so I didn't get to do that one. But all over the place. I mean, it was amazing to me. I felt like suddenly I was a rock star or something. Everybody, and in fact, the U.S. Postal Service, which a lot of people don't know, really wanted me to do a 30-day tour of different places. And I said, fine, I'm not a rock star. You know, but that would have been too much. But some of the places that really acknowledged it was when I was here in Greensboro, and I think that was in 98 or 99, I'm not sure what the exact year was. But my president right there, she was definitely here, and I had the first chance to work with the children and do several things here. And so I'm just really joyful to be back. And I have had a chance to speak in this room a couple of times. And the second time I didn't even recognize it because it was renovated, because it looked very different. Yeah, I was downstairs in the class or something rather than here. I'm just proud to be here, and I'm also proud to be, as of today, an honorary Bell. Thank you, Bell. Yes, very honored to be for that, really so. I will continue to come back, and I don't know, is it okay for me to make the announcement? Okay. We're gonna, after this week, we're gonna actually establish the scholarship fund in my name. So that's, So, I'm not sure how we're gonna get all the money, but we're gonna get the money. If my name means anything, we'll be able to give out some Synthia St. James scholarships to some of the art students. So that's in the works too. So you'll be seeing me around. And this is actually my first artist in residence. Okay, so Monday through Wednesday I have 6 classes and a public lecture. And should we announce, do you know anything we should do about that, Harry? Is it Tuesday at 5:30?
Tuesday at 5:30 in Joseph.
Okay, and it's open to the public. Right. So that'll be a time when you can really pick my brain again. So I'm not going to stay up here much longer, but I'm just going to also open, is there anybody who would like to ask me a couple of questions before I go sit down or walk around?
Would you explain?
Oh, sure, sure. I can do that in this room, but I could go like this. I could go, I could have Dr. Fusol be my Vanna White. Yes! Because she knows the painting, so she can do that kind of stuff great, you know. So starting at the top of the first four graduates, are the first four graduates in the 30s. I had so much fun with the women below them, looking up at them, because I enjoyed styling those 30s hats. So if you look at those hats, you know, and then the women, what I didn't get a chance to do, I did recognize the fact that the alumni, the National Alumni Association is there. That's the two women with the hats, embracing her, you know, bringing her in. And then that's, who is that? Who could that be? and then one of the parts I really loved was making her top of the bell. So she's a bell ringer. Since her head is the bell, top of the bell. Okay, and then the bell comes down all the way down all the side, and the students create the bell. So you've got the Bennett bell in there, and as I promised in last fall, if I ever make a lot of money, I'm gonna buy you a bigger bell. Yes. And then the other students around, or future students of Bennett, are just coming into the fold like fresh women. Okay? All right. And the color white is there too, because of the beard and gait, and some of the ceremonies that are all white. So you'll see a couple of students in white also. Yeah. Thank you.
How wonderful.
Okay, so any other questions, sir? Feel free to come up to me anytime.
So how long did it take you to
Well, is my friend here that gave me the tour? Is she here? She also won an award today. As a student, yeah. Well,
Ms. Royal Blue.
Yes, Ms. Royal Blue and White, yeah. What happened was I had spoken with Dr. Fuse Hall in September, I think it was September, yeah, last year. So this is like a baby in the making for more than 9 months, a whole year. And I was so excited about it that I asked if I could come and spend a couple of days here. And I had a chance to do a lecture and also visit some classes. And that began my research day. And then I went home and did a lot more research, and then I just had to start. So I would say with everything given together, I would say a couple of months. But then the other thing is that when you look at the painting, all those bright colors, the areas of color, there are about 8 coats of paint. Because that's what I do. I do between 7 and 9 coats of paint, so the painting is really vivid and the colors are really strong. So it may look simple, but it's not, meaning, you know, because you just see big areas of color, almost like a collage. Whereas if you look at any of my paintings with the sea or landscapes, that's with the oil, and that's like one application of mixture. I don't go back in those areas at all. So there's actually a lot more work that goes into the figurative pieces. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Is that Los Angeles chapter? Yeah. I met her today. Yeah, from where I live in Los Angeles. Anyone else? Don't be shy. Okay, well, if you'd like to come up to me anytime during the evening, I welcome any questions or comments. And thank you.
I had an opportunity to speak with Ms. St. James earlier today, and we were talking about the faces, and if you noticed, none of them have eyes or lips, or they're blank faces. And I admired that because when I make dolls, I don't put a face on a doll. people have to have imagination, and I think that's what the world is missing now, when children and when adults can't imagine. And I want to thank you for giving us this imagination, because I do see a couple of people in this picture over here I recognize. Thank you. And now, I would ask each of you to continue to enjoy walking around, talking with the artists and viewing the work. But before that, I would ask if our president, Dr. Rosalind Fuse Hall, would give her remarks.
You want to do it from here?
I think
we can do it from here. Great.
Good evening. Wow. Good evening, everyone. I am so pleased to see all of you here in the gallery. As Harry alluded to, we have friends of the arts at Bennett who are visiting with us this evening. Those of you who are friends of the arts at Bennett, would you just kind of wave your hand so people will know? We do have a little group called Friends of the Arts at Bennett. They get sneak peeks on our art exhibits, and they get help us to raise funds for the arts. So I am a big arts fan. When I got here, I immediately connected with Harry. We also used the President's Home as an extension of this gallery to show many of the works that we have. We have quite a nice collection. And so I hope that this will not be your first time. We have a packed show for this year, to the point that when I met Leroy Campbell, who will be one of our featured artists next year, I had to say, please come to Bennett, but oh, by the way, we're so full, we can't get you until next year. I'm a little bold like that, and I was like, please, please, please say yes, you're gonna come, please, please. So he will be one of our featured artists next year. So it's just really wonderful. Yeah, you can applaud for that, because he's great. So it is our goal to keep up the tradition of a Bennett Bell who is competent, confident, cultured, and committed to social justice. The four C's that you judge a diamond by, you can judge a Bennett Bell by. But we're so pleased and thank you so much for coming out this evening. Please enjoy the artwork and each other. And don't forget that tomorrow evening in the chapel, right across beyond the small bell, as Cynthia would say, in our chapel, we will be having our coronation for Miss Bennett College 2014-2015, Miss Jasmine Beckwith. We invite all of you out to please bring your friends and enjoy this regal occasion. And on Saturday morning at 10 o'clock a.m., we'll be back in the chapel to install the 17th president. And on Saturday night at the Corey Convention Center, we will boogie down with LTD. Have a nice scholarship gala to raise funds for our very dedicated students. And on Sunday morning, we will celebrate the founding of this great institution with Bishop Vashti McKenzie. I invite all of you to bring your friends and your sisters, to witness that wonderful occasion as we begin the next chapter in the life here at Bennett College. Thank you again for coming. Thank you, Planning Committee, for an extraordinary job. Buy the prints, you can do it right here at this window, and just enjoy each other and mingle in the rest of the gallery. Thank you so very much.
Thank you.
some point.